Welcome back to Get Baba. In this lecture, I am going to teach you the complete information about investment casting. So I am giving you three materials. You choose the best method to cast these materials. The first material is titanium. And the second one is tungsten. And the third material is platinum. By the way, I am giving you the melting point temperatures also. For titanium, it is 1668 degrees Celsius. Pretty high, right? And for tungsten, it is 3422 degrees Celsius. And for platinum, it is 1768 degrees Celsius. Okay, now you choose the best casting method to cast these materials. The first thought to come in our mind is sand casting. Does sand casting really cast these materials? No, because the sand melting point temperature is typically between 6050 to 7050. I told this information many times. Okay, so the sand melting point is 1650 to 1750, but I want to cast the material which is having higher temperature, very higher temperature than this range. So for example, if I take titanium, okay, the melting point temperature is 1660 degrees Celsius. It is between 1650 and 1750, so no problem. But we are not actually pouring the molten metal at the melting point temperature. We are heating the molten metal again. That means we are providing some super heat, so that the melting point temperature will increase to 1730 degrees Celsius up to. So this is pouring temperature. So we are pouring the molten metal 60 to 50 degrees Celsius above than the melting temperature. So that means at this temperature, the sand will definitely melt and fuse with the casting material that we don't want required. So that's why the king of casting has given birth. The casting process is investment casting. So it is the only unique characteristic of investment casting that no other process have. So the first important criteria to choose the casting process is melting point. So if I want to cast higher melting point temperature materials, then I have to do investment casting only. Okay, I can say it is the king of casting in my view. Okay, there is no limitation except cost. We can do cast complex shapes also. Yes, we can cast complex shapes and we can cast high melting materials. And the surface finish obtained by this casting method is also very high, 1.62 3.2 micrometer. So with this casting, we can do complex shapes, we can produce high melting materials, and we can produce high surface finish also. So it has no limitation practically except the cost. Okay, that's why it is called king of casting in my view. So what is the other name of investment casting? The other name for investment casting is lost wax. The name itself, investment casting. So we are investing something to get the casting. So here what we are investing? Wax. Wax material we are investing here. So we are investing wax material and with that we are getting the casting. Now let us see the procedure, how we do that. I have given a beautiful diagram over here. You can see it. So it is the investment casting equipment to do the job. The first we have to make a pattern like sand casting. So the pattern is made by these mold boxes, and there is a special thing that I want to tell you here. The pattern T, you can see here the third part, the pattern T can be directly made by centrifuging. No need to do with mold boxes, no need to do with die casting, no need to eject the pattern again and assemble that with gating elements. All these things can be done at a time by centrifuging. So it is the cheapest method to produce multiple pattern materials with included gating elements. So please make a note this, right? Centrifuging is the only casting method to produce the patterns, multiple patterns with included gating elements. Okay. And now the pattern material, the pattern assembly is dipped into the slurry coating. So what is the composition of slurry coating? Here, from process to process, the molding material is changing. So here the molding material compositions are, I mean slurry coating composition is, it is a combination of silica floor, plus ethyl silicate, and added some amount of water. So this is a slurry coating composition. We are dipping the pattern tea in the slurry coating and allowing it some time, and then we take that out. Okay, after taking this out, we are again dipping that into ceramic powder. Right, so why to choose ceramic powder? I told earlier also, we are using the investment casting method for high melting point materials. So the best material that can resist these much temperatures is ceramic only. No other metal can resist these melting point materials at cheaper cost. So our best material is ceramic. That's why we are choosing ceramic powder, and we are dipping the slurry coated pattern assembly into the ceramic powder. So a fine grained ceramic powder is covered with over the pattern assembly and forms a shell. Okay, so by the way, the pattern material is wax. That means candle wax. Okay, candle wax. This is the completed mold. After mold is prepared, dewaxing is done. Dewaxing is nothing but removing of wax pattern by heating the ceramic core. That means we are removing the pattern material from the core. So then only the cavity will be produced within the core. So in that cavity, we pour directly molten metal. After solidification, we break the shell and we get our required casting. Okay. So by the way, the ceramic powder coating is also called as stucco coating. These two combinations coating is called as stuccoing. Stuccoing process. So what are the applications and limitations? We will see here. I told you earlier also, we are using this casting technique for high melting point materials. The major application is for high melting point materials because there is no other process that can do this job. Okay, in die casting we are using die material. So die material melting point temperature is pretty lower than when I compare to tungsten. Okay, and sand casting, we know that the melting point temperature is 1650 only, so we cannot use that. There is no way. So the main important characteristic of this casting is high melting point materials. So I am writing some of the applications. So these are all the applications, the main applications of investment casting. So by the way, I am giving you some extra information about this. The cast turbine blades are made by mnemonic alloys. Okay, and jet engine parts are made by titanium. And the medical implants, for example, knee replacements. Examiner may give any related medical implant, but you have to choose the investment casting based on medical implant. He doesn't give the medical implant directly. He will give some of the body parts. Okay. and the dentures. Dentures are nothing but medical knives. And gold ornaments. Gold ornaments are platinum ornaments. These are nothing but jewelry. Sorry, the spelling for jewelry, J-E. And this whole process is done in vacuum to minimize gas defects. That's why it is costly process. So what are the limitations that it has? The only main limitation is cost. Maintaining vacuum, laborious and time consuming. These two are backwards reasons, but these first and second is main reason, main limitations of investment casting. So always remember one thing, only limitations push the limits of inventions. Okay, so don't limit yourself. If I am limited with sand casting, I am not able to produce the platinum castings or tungsten castings or titanium castings. So there is no way to cast these gas turbine blades. So that's why don't limit yourself. Push your limits. Thank you.